Thank you. We want to thank y'all so much for coming up and spending a little time with the Larry McCray Band. We're all based out of Michigan. We got Mr. Clif Metcalf over here from Holland, Michigan on keyboard. My main man from Flint, Michigan, Mr. Greg Nagy on guitar. D. Washington is on drums. He's from Grand Rapids, Michigan. And my partner in crime and other things, Mr. Joe Velos. We go way back a long time. How about it for Joe Velos? He's from Detroit, Michigan on bass guitar. And we all thank y'all for being here. Thank you so much. We're promoting our latest release. It's only a year old this time. Last time I hadn't had one after 8 years, so I feel like I'm pretty current right now. But we still having fun promoting this, and hopefully you guys are enjoying the music too. Thank you so much for your support. We got something right here called The Good Die Young. Why the hell am I still here? Oh.
I did something wrong.
Guitar players, and I'm just happy to even be here. I ain't got no business here, but it's very intimidating. You got the great Mr. Joe Bonamassa, Mr. Craig Fletcher, Mr. Henry James, just to name some of the ones that I can call you off the top of my head, and it's such an honor to be here to be playing on this cruise for you guys. I hope y'all know what it means to us, and we thank you for it. Coming up next on our list is a song that we're going to do, and it's called Without Love, What Does It Matter? And if you was here yesterday, you heard me tell the same story. This song was written by me and my baby, Miss Peggy Smith. And it wasn't that we were together during the pandemic. I spent the first 100 in about 25 days by myself. And man, I'm sitting up there at the crib. I'm scared to go outside. I'm scared to breathe too hard, you know, because they didn't nobody know what was going on. And it was all about wake up people. Wake up people, hell, I'm woke. Now what the hell am I supposed to do? So it was really alarming, and I'm sure it was for you as well. But what it made me realize that being by myself for a little over 3 months, that man, you know, when you're all alone, if you don't have love in your life, if you don't have camaraderie, if you don't have something, you don't have nothing. You know, if there's no love in your life, what do you have? So this song is called Without Love, What Does It Matter? And as one certain one in our band, he's got a chicken filter on his phone. He say, without a piece of chicken, it ain't no good either, so. We have to watch him, he navigate for us sometime, and if we start seeing too many chicken places, we know we done got our course, if you know what I mean. Without love, what does it matter? Nothing, right, people? baby's gone. Lord have mercy. And she ain't resurging my career for me, because I had been on a long, dusty, hot road, and it was brought me a parasol, brought me some shade. And I can't do nothing but thank them, because again, it's the reason that I'm here right now, and I love you guys to death for what they did for me. They're some great people, and I thank them for it. This song right here, if I can find my pick again, I dropped my lecture. This is called The Blue River. We still like playing it, and it's just a little instrument, something you can lay back and tap your foot to if you feel like. Thank you. Doug ain't drunk. I wish I was drinking. This is for all the grown folks in the house. All the grown folks in the house know what I'm talking about because they've been together for a while, and I'm sure you might have hit a bump in the road every now and then, but nothing worth having is definitely worth working for. And to have good love, you gotta start from the bottom. This song is called Down to the Bottom, dedicated to all of you.
We
I gotta set this one up because I think you'll find a little amusement in this story. This was written by a very good friend of mine. His name was Clif also, but he's no longer with us. And Clif, at this particular time, was probably about 76 years old. And this song was written by me and a friend of mine by the name of Mr. Charlie Wamsley. And me, him, and Clif used to work in a little band together. And so Clif was very smooth with the ladies. And so at 76 years old, he still had about six or seven of them on the line at one time. So one time, we were sitting at Chuck's house. Clif had a lady on the phone. He had a lady knocking on the door at the same time. So somehow or another, my friend Charlie come up with the concept of Mr. Easy. He said, "You call me Mr. Easy, but you don't call me Easy Long, because when things get complicated, I pack my bags and I'm gone." So this is dedicated to my late friend, Mr. Clif, and I hope y'all like our show.
Thank you.
That you like being around and being with. These some pretty good old fellas here. And I'm happy to be playing with them. I really am. Take it way back one more time to the Delta Hurricane days. This one is called The Last Four Nickels. Trying to call my baby in the telephone. She went home. You know how damn long ago this.
Thank you.
KTAB jam tonight, and I promise we're doing it tonight. Yes, sir, I promise you that. Yes, sir. All right, thank you. We're going to take you home with something that we've been doing since 1991. And this is a song, it's a Warren Haynes song made very popular by the Allman Brothers. But we were doing it about 5 years before they were. I got a chance to meet Warren Haynes in the late 80s. And back in them days, they had cassette tapes, you remember those? He come, when we got together for the session, he had four 90-minute cassette tapes with all fully produced songs, all of his own songs. And later, a lot of the other songs also became hits for the Allman Brothers, such as Maydell, She's a Pro, She Broke the Needle, She Can't Sew, Who to Believe, and Soul Shine was one of the ones. So out of curiosity, I asked him, I said, well, Warren, how come you haven't released these songs? I mean, the demos were fully produced and sound like records. He said, well, I've been trying to get Greg to listen to this thing for 4 or 5 years and I ain't never got it yet. So after it was all said and done, we made it recorded and we parted ways, and I saw him again about a year or so later. And he said that him and Alan Woody was riding on the bus together, and they were playing my CD after it had released with the Soul Shine song of it. And so he said, Greg, come back to where they was at, and said, who the hell is that? He says, Larry McCray. He said, I've been trying to give you that song for 10 years. So after they put the song out and we would play it, people would say, you playing an Allman Brothers song? And I would say, yes, sir, but we were doing it years before they put it out. And of course, nobody believed me. That was the sweet part about it. You tell the truth and sometimes people still don't want to accept you, but it's the goddamn truth, I promise you. So we're going to go home with that one, and that's going to be specially played and dedicated to you also. Thank y'all so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
up for my very good friend, the lovely Mrs. Nagy Rose. Give it up for Nagy. Nagy and I had a chance to hang out and get to know each other on the Almond family reunion this fall, this wintertime. And she's such a sweet person. She says she's going to give a big, fat, gentle cat and name him Larry McCray. I can't wait to meet Larry McCray. I love you all. I love you, Nagy Rose. I love these fellas here. Thank y'all so very much. We hope to see you again before it's all said and done. Thank y'all.